Good morning everyone. Today we will be studying about the circulatory system. The circulatory system consists of heart and the blood vessels. So first of all, we'll be discussing about the blood vessels, the types of blood vessels which are present in the circulatory system. Now, what are blood vessels? The blood vessels, they are the branch tubes which are extending from the heart to all parts of the body. These blood vessels, they are transporting blood to the different parts of the body, and they are bringing blood from the different parts of the body to the lungs also for oxygenation. Now, their blood vessels, they are of three types: arteries, veins and capillaries. One by one, we'll be studying about the structure and the functions which they perform. Now, what is an artery? An artery carries blood from heart towards any organ. So, artery carries the oxygenated blood, the blood which contains more of oxygen. And arteries, thick muscular walls are present in the arteries. They have a narrow lumen and blood flows in spurts. Now, by thick narrow lumen, we mean that there is a central bore in the artery. I'll show you the diagram. And blood flows in the spurts. So when the ventricles, they contract, the blood flows in the spurts in the arteries. Then we have the veins. It carries blood away from an organ towards the heart. Now, these veins which are present, they carry basically all the veins, they carry the deoxygenated blood, the blood which contains more of carbon dioxide. Now, thin muscular walls are present in the veins in comparison to the arteries, which have thick muscular walls. Then in the veins, they have a wider lumen. Arteries, they have narrow lumen. Then blood flows uniformly in the veins. And walls are present in the veins. Now, these walls which are present, they are pocket-shaped walls. These are the openings. And these walls help the blood to flow only in one direction. So, it is preventing the back flow of the blood. Right? Now, if we consider the structure of both the arteries and the veins, what is the structure? Now, there are in the center, they have a central bore present. Now, arteries, they have a narrow lumen, and veins, they have a wider lumen in comparison to the arteries. Then there are three layers present in the arteries: the inner layer, the middle layer and the external layer. This is your inner layer, middle layer and the external layer. Now, the inner layer which is there, it is formed of endothelium and it is known as tunica interna. The middle layer which is present, it is known as tunica media, and this middle layer is composed of smooth muscles and elastic fibers are present in the middle layer, in both the middle layers. Then we have an outer layer which is known as the external layer, also known as tunica externa. Now, this layer, it is composed of the connective tissue and it is the outer layer which is present. There is a difference that in the veins you have walls present and the walls are absent in the arteries. So, reason I've already told you, to prevent the backflow of the blood. Now, the arteries which are present, they carry the oxygenated blood, but there is an exception. That exception is pulmonary artery. Now, the pulmonary artery which is present, the pulmonary artery, it carries the deoxygenated blood. Except the pulmonary artery, all the arteries, they carry oxygenated blood. And the veins, they carry the deoxygenated blood which contains carbon dioxide laden blood, except the pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein carries the oxygenated blood. Now, while discussing the structure of the heart, we'll discuss how they function the pulmonary artery and the vein. Now, why the blood flow in spurts in the arteries? Because they flow with jerks, because they are under great pressure. And in veins, the blood flows continuously and there is less pressure in the veins. So that is why the blood flows in spurts in the arteries. Another difference is that the arteries which are present, they are usually deeper in the skin, and the veins which are present, they are near to the skin, so they are superficial. Now the arteries, they can also break and form smaller arteries known as arterioles, and whereas the veins, they can break into small veins which are known as venules. The third type of vessel, blood vessel, which is there, that is known as the capillary. It is a narrow tube and it is formed of single layer of squamous epithelial cells, also known as endothelium. And there are no muscles present in the blood capillaries. And you will see that this structure, it is formed of only a single layer of epithelial cells, the endothelium. That's all. And then if you consider about the functions of the capillaries, they help in the outward diffusion of the gases. Outward diffusion. Now, what do you mean by that? That when from the intercellular fluid, the oxygen enters the intercellular fluid and from there into the tissue cells. So from outside, it is allowing the diffusion of oxygen inside. Then it also allows the inward diffusion. Now, what is inward diffusion? That it allows the inward diffusion of carbon dioxide from the intercellular fluid. So, from the intercellular fluid, the diffusion of carbon dioxide will take place through the capillaries. Then it allows the diffusion of the substances like glucose, amino acids, urea, hormones. So it allows the in and outward movement of these substances. Then through the capillary walls, the leukocytes, or you can say the WBCs, which are present, the white blood cells, the leukocytes, they squeeze out through the capillary walls by the amoeboid movement, which is known as, also known as diapedesis. So through that they squeeze out. Then there is another term which we use, which is known as vasoconstriction and vasodilation. Now, what is the difference between these two terms? Now, vasoconstriction is when they constrict or when they contract the blood vessels or the capillaries, when they contract. And vasodilation is when they dilate. Now, when the capillaries, they dilate, they increase the blood flow. And when they contract, they decrease the blood flow or the blood supply to the various parts of the body. So you must have noticed that when you walk in the hot sun, your face, it turns pink. Why it turns pink? Because the there is increased blood supply. And similarly in the cold, your face turns bluish because the blood vessels, the capillaries, they contract. They contract so to avoid the heat loss, and in that case there is reduced blood flow. Now, if you see this diagram, you will see that when the blood enters through the arteries, they are further branched into the arterioles, and from the arterioles, the blood goes to the capillaries. And in between the these, you will see that intercellular space is present, which is filled with the fluid. So exchange of the substances takes place in the capillaries. Then from there, the blood goes into the capillaries where deoxygenated blood is there. And then the deoxygenated, after delivering the oxygen, then the deoxygenated blood goes to the venules, which are smaller branches of the veins. And from the venules, then it goes to the veins, and then vein carry the deoxygenated blood. And in between, if you'll see, there is a lymph vessel present, which will provide the lymph to the intercellular spaces. About lymph, we'll discuss in the lymphatic system in detail. So for now, it is that from the artery, it goes to the arteriole, then the capillaries, and capillaries then carry the blood to the venule and then the veins. I hope it is clear. Thank you.